Today, I decided to give a try to the Tamiya P-47. Even though this kit has almost 20 years in the market, it's still one of the best kits of the P-47 you can get at this scale. As you can see, it has a nice detailed instructions and three main sprues with options for different configurations and ordnance. The P-47 had a darker cockpit than the usual interior green that you can see in most US aircraft for this era. I decided to give a bit of depth, adding a lighter tone to the mixture, followed by a wash to make the details pop even more. For the seatbelt, I decided to use the decal, but as it is so fragile, I placed it over aluminium foil to stiffen it up a little. For the rivets, I looked for blueprints online and some reference pictures to see if they were noticeable on real pictures, and evaluate if it's worth the effort. Thank you. After this, I sand the rivets smooth to the surface and remove the dust with a polishing wheel, which will also help for the upcoming natural metal finish. The interior of the cowling of most of the P-47s were anodized aluminum, which I represented using medium gray. For the natural metal finish, I wanted to get some tonal variation. I got the effect using Tamiya smoke. If you think you overdone the effect, you can always go back with your metallic base paint and tone down the effect. Red paint doesn't have good coverage properties, so it's always a good practice to give a white coat to get a more vibrant color. I decided to represent this aircraft from the 405th Fighter Group. This aircraft was flown by the First Lieutenant Bob Hartmann. I have always loved this scheme on the Razorback, and the Jabo was one of my favorites from this fighter group. If you are using decal solvents and your decal starts to wrinkle, don't panic, let it dry, don't touch it, those are the solvents doing their thing. I use the brown Tamiya wash. To remove it, I use a kitchen towel moisted in white spirit. For the gunsmoke and exhaust, I am using Tamiya pigments, which I think works amazingly well for this task. Don't be like me, be careful when masking over decals. If you don't cover them properly with a gloss coat, tape can leave them, and no one wants a heart attack. We'll be right back. And that's all for this video. I hope you liked it, and if you have, slap the like button and subscribe to the channel to see more of my videos.